The most economically important diseases in dairy cattle are foot and mouth disease, mastitis, hemorrhagic septicemia, anthrax, black quarter, brucellosis, and milk fever. The main symptoms of foot and mouth diseases are fever, blisters in the mouth and on the feet, drop in milk production, weight loss, loss of appetite, quivering lips and frothing of mouth, blisters on teats, and lameness. The main cause of foot and mouth diseases are: the disease is caused by a virus which can be transmitted through air, feeding materials, direct contact, through vehicles and farm equipments. To prevent foot and mouth disease, foot and mouth disease outbreaks are usually controlled by periodical vaccination to build individual animal or herd immunity. Strict biosecurity and quarantine measures are important to control the spread of the disease. The main symptoms of mastitis are changes in the appearance of milk, such as watery, flakes, clots, blood or pus, udder swelling, heat, hardness, redness or pain, reduction in milk yields, fever, reduced feed intake, and a reduction in mobility due to the pain of a swollen udder. The main cause of mastitis are: the disease is mainly caused by a bacteria which can be transmitted through unhygienic environment, such as contaminated milk utensils, dirty floor, unhygienic milker and milking machine. To prevent mastitis, mastitis can be controlled by strict overall hygienic environment and good milking management practices. Regular dipping, prompt treatment of infected animals, and maintenance of records are important to control mastitis. The main symptoms of hemorrhagic septicemia are: the majority of cases in cattle and buffalo are acute with death. The majority of cases in cattle and buffalo are acute with death occurring from 6 to 24 hours. Sudden onset of high fever, salivation and nasal discharge. Edematic swelling are seen in the pharyngeal region and then it spreads up to brisket. Dullness, reluctance to move. Visible mucous membranes are congested. And respiratory diseases occurs like dyspnea, shortness of breath, etc. Respiratory distress with frothing at the mouth. The main causes of hemorrhagic septicemia are: the disease is caused by a bacteria which can be transmitted through direct contact or transmitted indirectly through contaminated water and feed. To prevent hemorrhagic septicemia, Hemorrhagic septicemia outbreaks are usually controlled by periodic vaccination. Proper stress management also helps to reduce the incidence. The main symptoms of anthrax are sudden death, often within 2 or 3 hours of being apparently normal, is by far the most common sign. After death, tarry colored, unclotted blood discharged from the natural orifice such as nose, ear, and rectum. The main cause of anthrax are: the disease is caused by a bacteria which can be transmitted through direct contact with infected animals or indirectly through air, contaminated water, and feed. To prevent anthrax, it is a zoonotic disease, therefore, don't open the carcass of the suspected animal. Dead animal should be deeply buried with superficial disinfectant application. Anthrax outbreaks are usually controlled by periodical vaccination. The main symptoms of black water are lameness, unwillingness to move, crepitating sound on pressing the affected part of muscle, loss of appetite, rapid breathing, and fever. The main cause of black water are: the disease is caused by a bacteria. To prevent black water, periodical vaccination before the onset of rainy season. The main symptoms of brucellosis are abortion, stillbirth, that is death within 24 hours after calving, weak calf bone, retention of fetal membranes, signs of infection in the membranes, swollen testicles in bulls. Infection of the testicles is also seen in bulls. The main cause of brucellosis are: the disease is caused by a bacteria. To prevent brucellosis, vaccination should be done about 6 months of age, which is called as a calfhood vaccination. Periodical diagnosis and culling of affected animal. The main symptoms of milk fever are: usually milk fever occurs 48 hours before and after calving. Sternal recumbency followed by lateral recumbency. Cow succeeds in rising, she staggers and will very soon fall. The heart can be slow and arrhythmic. Fever, loss of appetite, constipation, restlessness, and difficulty in standing. The main causes of milk fever are mainly due to calcium deficiency during calving period. To prevent milk fever, treatment with calcium injected by intravenous and subcutaneous routes. Avoid calcium supplementation 3 to 4 weeks before calving. The major protozoan diseases like babesiosis, theileriosis, anaplasmosis, trypanosomiasis, and coccidiosis. The main symptoms of babesiosis is coffee-colored urine. In case of telluriosis, swelling of lymph nodes, fever, and diarrhea are the common symptoms. Anemia is a predominant symptom of anaplasmosis. Intermittent fever, anemia, and weight loss are the major symptoms of trypanosomiasis. Coccidiosis mostly occur in calves with bloody diarrhea with straining. To prevent protozoan diseases, prompt treatment with specific drug and effective control measures for ectoparasites are highly useful. The main symptoms of ectoparasites like ticks, lice, and mites are excitement, itching, irritation, abscesses on skin. The main causes of ectoparasites are hot and humid living conditions, unclean animal and surroundings, overcrowding and indoor housing, contact of infested animals, building and pasture. To prevent the ectoparasites, keep the animal shed clean and surroundings also clean. Keep the animal shed and the surroundings clean. Wash and groom the animals regularly. Inspect the animals, especially the hidden parts, regularly and spray them as soon as lice or ticks are noticed. Isolate the affected animals and treat them separately. Apply sulfur mixed in coconut or peanut in the ratio 3:1. Spray the animals with suitable insecticides at periodic interval. In serious cases, inject the animals with suitable preparations like ivermectin. Supplement minerals in the diet. Use mechanical groomers in the housing. Allow the animals for wallowing. The main symptoms of endoparasites like roundworm, tapeworm, and lungworms are listlessness, diarrhea, blood-tinged stools, distended abdomen, and bottle jaw. The main causes of endoparasites are unhealthy keeping conditions and malnutrition, contact with infested animal, water supply, pasture, or fecal material, intermediate hosts like flies, ticks also help their spread. Ingestion of soil, leaking of walls, gates, and infested floors. To prevent endoparasites, keep the pens and premises clean and dry. Remove dung and store in a compost pit at a safe distance. Composting kills the parasites and their eggs. Ensure clean drinking water. If grazing is practiced, then maintain the grazing rotation and practice periodic burning of pastures. Have a fecal sample tested in laboratory and follow recommended medication. Follow the deworming schedule for young calves strictly. Deworm them at 2 weeks and thereafter at monthly interval up to 6 months. Deworm older calves every 3 months. 2 deworming, one each before and after rainy seasons, are of vital significance in northern India.